Hi, welcome to RoboJax. In this video, we are going to see how we can use this 1602 LCD, which has 16 characters and two rows, with the I2C module using these four wires only, so we can print text. The code for this project will be available by clicking at the link in the description. You can get it, or you can go directly visit robojax.com/learn/Arduino. So let's get started. So the module, this display, liquid crystal display or LCD, has 16 characters by two. So 16 characters in two lines. So we have 1, 2, 3 up to 16 and then another 16. So that's why it's called 1602. So 16 and then 2. And this has tons of wires to connect if we don't use the I2C module. So this module is specifically designed for this one. So you just, so this module has four pins because I2C can work with the two wires. So we have the VCC and then we have a ground and then we have SDA and the SCL, the clock, the data and the clock. So there are two wires needed and then the power. Then the power will be supplied also to the LCD. So the only thing that you need is to, when you receive the package, if it's not soldered, just solder it here and then you plug it in. But if you are installing it in a device or something, that make sure that you just solder it with a very little header out. If you're not installing anything, doesn't matter, so this can sit properly and it can be soldered this way. So now I'm going to solder this to prepare it for the tutorial. So I want to make sure that this is inserted fully and then just apply some solder here. So that pin is done. I will apply also at the end. Now the rest will be very easy. So now this has been soldered. So at this point of I2C module, we have the address here, A0, A1, A2. So this is not soldered. This point can be soldered together. So this is not soldered. All of them are zero. So we can select combination of soldering in terms of digital. So this is 0, 0. And then also we can make it one. So this can be 0 and this can be 1 and these two are 0 and so forth. Here are the values. So if everything is 0, then we have 27. So the order is like this, A2, A1, A0. So, and then if we have only A0 is 1, then the address will be 0x26. So 0x mean hex value of 26 and so forth. So all these are the all combinations, so up to this tree, which is 15 different values. This jumper is here to control this LED. If you don't want this one to be on, you can just leave it, and you can see it's very dark, but let me change the intensity. At the maximum intensity, it looks like this. So let me explain how you connect this. So this module has four wires, ground, VCC, SDA, and SCL. The DA is the data, CL is the clock. So these will be connected accordingly here. So the VCC, is connected this is a VCC connected to 5 volts. The ground is connected to the ground, and these two wires are, so the clock is connected to A5, and the data DA is connected to A4. Some Arduinos might have here SCL and SDA, so make sure if yours have it, you can directly connect it. I just connected it here because it works in both cases. I will provide the link so you can come here and download the library. Also, this library will be provided directly on robojax.com, so you can get it in case it's changed or moved. So once you arrive at this page, just click clone and click on the zip, select the location. I'm going inside the download and then library and then saving it. After it's finished, just go open it. So however you use Edge or Firefox, so this is a file. Now right click, you can get 7-zip, which is free from 7-zip.org. extract here, it will create a folder with the same name. That's the file. So right click, copy, and then go to Arduino folder wherever you installed it. Maybe you installed it in program file Arduino, so mine is here. So anyway, you will see this structure, and inside the library, just go here somewhere on the empty spot, just click right click and download it, and somewhere on the here, on here, right click paste, right click and select paste. So this will be the folder with all the files. So let me explain the code now. The wire is for communication purpose of I2C, and this is the main library that does the job for us. And then we create here, using this type, we create an object LCD. 0x27 is the address. For this purpose of working with address, I've created a separate video that explains everything. But for majority of I2C, the address is 0x27, so if you type that, it will work. 16 is number of characters, 2 is number of rows, so I believe you will not change that. And inside the setup, so we say LCD begin, so this is an object, we just say LCD, and then the method begin will initialize it. So then we say set the backlight, backlight will be on after that. Then inside the loop, we say clear this loop. Every time we run, it will clear it, and then we type one text. So we say lcd.print, and then inside the double quote, we put our text, whatever you want. To print on the next line, we say set cursor at 0, 1. 0 mean the character 0 at the beginning of the line, and 1 mean second row, because the row start with 0, so row 0, row 1. And then lcd print, this text will go at this address. And then we wait 500 milliseconds or less, and it goes and continues like that. So if you are reading the value from a sensor, from something else, or a voltage or pressure or temperature, whatever, so your loop will go here, you get the value, and then put it here, and it will be printed for you. So now let's open the cursor blank example. Blinking cursor. So here is for the cursor blink. We use lcd.blink. As you can see, the cursor will blink like that. And when there is no blink, as you can see, there is no blink. It will be just a line. So blink and no blink. So you either use no blink or you use blink. So this screen uses a while loop to just display that, which is part of the example. Let's open another example. Go to file, example, scroll to the crystal library, and then custom character. With this custom characters, they've created bell, note, clock, heart, duck, and all those. For each, there is a hex value that represents how the text is being drawn on the screen. So here is an example that somebody has created this battery, so empty and full battery for this character too. And here is the map of the each character on this device. And these are the hex values. So actually each character has 1, 2, 3, 4. Each character has 5 dots, 8 dots. So and here the battery have been drawn like that. And these are 1, 1, 1, and the greens are 0. So 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. So for this, you have to send 0x to draw that one, and next, and so forth. So all these value will draw this battery shape. Somebody else has created this map that you can see all these characters that if you need them, you just click here, and here is a value if you want to print 5. So this is the hex value for all of them. So you will send 01F, 0118, and so forth. This example prints the special characters with all of those. So here are the characters that code prints. It goes from 10 hex to 20 hex. Here are the values that are being printed, and from 30 to 40, these are the values. 40 to 50, these are the values. These are all hex values. 50 to 60, uppercase yen sign, and lowercase 60 to 70. And as you can see, it continues like that with arrow. So it tries to get all the ASCII characters that it can print, and now you can see some Japanese character that you can see. From E to F. And now you see these shapes, 0 to 10, these are the heart and all those things that have been drawn. So this was introduction to this 1602 LCD. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video. Please subscribe and also share. If you have any question, please post it in the comments. I appreciate it and I will try my best to answer it. I will have a lot of other videos using this LCD with different applications. So please follow up.